to have it, didn't they, the Devils? Just had to. Karen KC. And at number 8. Yeah, because Alex Davies was so rather ambitious with lack of footwork to the max. Lewis is still upset here. Oh, well.
Just when Pune Devils, that run rate was excellent at the start. We are well old. Excellent delivery. Good over. 66 for 6.
And it's a bit like that, really, after a birthday and a half. And it's only just getting started. Well, we love it here in the UAE. Abu Dhabi with season 4 of the Alubon TT. Here is Ryan Inmott. And there's Hardison Hill. He's not playing. Fell on the ball, he was telling me, prior to the coin toss, he landed on there on his IT band. Landed heavily on it in the field. And that's why he's something like I had a cork bow on his neck and side.
Yeah, it's never a nice feeling. And that ITB is normally tight anyway as athletes. You see those foam rollers in the S&C kind of kit and they pull them out and almost self-massage.
There's that bounce. This is what happens here in the evening. A particular third match, now that it's kicked over 9 o'clock local time, Hardison Ewan was saying this too. He said, very frustrating that he's not playing in this, and they tended to play more day games, the Devils. And he was saying this, he reckons, is probably one of the quicker pitches of the main part of the square, the central part of this pitch area. And he said, he's a bit miffed that he's injured. He'd love to have another go here. Yeah, good zip. Up to 22 yards.
Yeah, well, certainly the Northern Warriors are used to playing the night game. There's Kenar Lewis. Still going, still discussing. I like his watch, by the way. This is the dismissal. Yeah, he doesn't think he's hit it. What? I'm out. Seriously? Rubbish.
Up and over the skipper. Is it safe? Yeah. Luckily, just enough wood on it. And Simmons couldn't get there. Yeah. And I was just pop under the stands, gonna have a net. Bent a bit of spleen and get him in the nets. John, to be said, well, we'll come for a run with me then. We'll go for a quick run of 10 pounds. Ain't happening. Sorry, George. Curran. A bold red in it.
Yeah, given the stage that they're at, the projected score going at 10 runs and over. They'll just get to 100. You get a sense with these two, they just don't feel comfortable with pace on, do they? Pace on and back of the length. They seem to be jumping around a fair bit.
Right, I think so. Just a little too short here. The idea is right. Just not quite with the execution.
Could almost expect that, couldn't you, after seeing them hopping and skipping in the popping crease. So Wouldn't be surprised if they go a little bit shorter, ribs, that type of thing, and then try to set the batter up and then go full Yorker length to try and knock him over.
And the other one. Nice change up. Seven done. 70 for six here. Pune Devils, they were asked to bat first by Nicholas Perron. It's not gone great, as just been said. Captain, the gloves and pads on, he's just having a look around, just having a look at the field. And more zip. Almost on cue, almost all of them. One on the far right, they're just a little flutter. Yeah, they're all subtly different, aren't they? Just but it's amazing. After 9 p.m., the breeze just subsides, dies away.
Yeah, and then the dew sets in, doesn't it? And so the second innings, the ball starts to skid on nicely. Shot. Well, Hussain now thinking, right, I've got to dance down the wicket and generate a bit of pace going in front of the wicket.
Let's get it on as well. And off the blade. Oh, yeah, very flamboyant through the offside. The captain, Nasser Hussain. Thanks very much.
First boundary after three overs, desperately needed by the Pune Devils.
Yeah, let's follow the ball because that man is right there. Looks for cover on the fence. Find something a little tricky here. As we're saying, not much happening.
No, not much happens when it's that length, is it? Both Curran and Hussain just aren't quite sure what to do. How to play it. Hello, Graham. We have gotten some beautiful shots from that, especially as the sun was setting. I'm surprised, given that it's your birthday, Danny, why you weren't up there kind of navigating it. Bit of fun?
Yes, for you.
Oh.
You're sleeping in there, huh? Come on. Look at the Warriors. They're on the program stands. This is the Super League stage of season 4. Yeah, the Devils, they're on their way out. They're just going to partake much more of T10 here on January 2021. Exciting though, because end of the year, this will be back in its normal slot of November. Here another derby, nice in November, they'll be back here for another bit of tea time. Of course, it was supposed to be last November, but of course with the pandemic and the IPL coming to these shores, changed it up. Oh, hello and goodbye. Wow, was right. What a strike.
Oh. Could he be the Dream 11 game changer just to get them over that three-figure mark? They need it. They need something for their bowlers to bowl to. Nice strike. Came out of nowhere.
It came out of the middle enough. Oh, yes. What a cracker. So, bowler Junaid Siddiqui, he knows. Showed a little clip there too of Parnell having a chat with Porun. Just assessing strategy, tweaking the fields. starting to branch out here, and the confidence is flowing from the skipper. 13 off the 8, that's 83 for 6 now. Saying, nice ball. What have we got here, Lisa?
Yeah, a little bit of chat. I think that both these teams aren't playing for the win. It means something, and you can see that. There's egos, there's performances, there's reselection in this competition, as you were saying, this November.
From Sadiq, it wasn't in English. He's got right over the head of Nasser Sahin. Oh, gorgeous.
Just within two balls, we've seen two different emotions.
And then two different fielders too, swapping and moving. Look at Anderson on the boundary. Cross-batted. It's good because he's done the right thing and given the strike back to the skipper, Nasser Sahin. Good stuff from Alan KC.
He's taken a leaf out of his skipper's book by dancing down the pitch. Try and create some power, some momentum, because at the moment for them, standing still and trying to hit hasn't necessarily worked.
That's so quick and zippy, but it's just a little too short, says Alex Wharf to his good mate Ramon Martinez, and he's the one for the over as well. Really good zip through here. Too short. And Parnell.
He's not a tall man, is he? He's in Hussain. So he's going to go around the stumps. Just change the angle slightly. Field hasn't changed at all.
It's almost a new telegraph. With that protection on the leg side, he could try and cramp up Nasser Hussain, who was waiting. Half the over gone, they'll throw the wide in there. And, let's see what else they can do. 12s from here. I know we've only got an over and a half. Can they get past 100? He's a tough gig for the Devils. Zingers are alight. We've got number 7 at that lovely number for Lisa Stalaker, the Aussie.
Yeah, it strikes, doesn't it? Comes around the wicket, cuts down the angle, hits the top of off. Good catch by Nicholas Baran as well behind the stumps. Yeah, Wayne Parnell again in the wickets. He's picked up 3 wickets. They're just going to check the back foot, no ball. This is the problem with left-handers when they come around the wicket. Sometimes they get close. Oh, fine. He's well inside. Yeah, he's actually got plenty of room to go if he wants. So, Curran. He's the last batter out. And he goes for 3. It's the Devils are 87 for 7.
he's almost got another one. He's got 3 for 5 as Wayne Parnell hunting up another one. He wasn't far away here. And he's got one delivery left. That's a beauty. And it goes through to Nicky P. Well done, son.
Yeah, he nearly had 4, didn't he? So close to hitting the stumps. That's where he's targeting. Ninth overdone, 87 for 7.